got to the MCN office this morning. Potski, the boss, promised me cutting-edge sports bike test on track with some proper TT and Northwest Road Racers. Well, sadly, it's a bit lacking. It's 125s. However, these bikes are draped in quality parts. You've got upside-down forks, you've got quick shifters, they look the part, and they're all around 4 grand or under. So what we're going to do, we're going to have a little road test about 80 miles on each bike. Liam from our website is going to be filming, and I'm going to be riding with Steve Mercer and Bruce Dunn. And then we're going to go to our proving ground, find out which one's the quickest, and then eventually, fingers crossed, if they all survive, get them on track, set some lap times, and just have complete carnage and see which one's the most fun. Minutes of what can only be described as a dangerous riding competition where nobody shuts off for anything. I've got to lose my rucksack because I've got some severe drag and my Aprilia's not going quick enough.
I got a terrible start.
I was in the grass verge. I was next to it and I got pushed into the grass verge.
Brilliant.
Testing. But that's the road riding over with, and our little kind of verdicts so far. Mercer, which one's going to go quickest?
I reckon the Spanish Rieju will go quickest in a straight line. I don't know if it'll be the best around the track, but we'll have to wait and see. I think the Yamahas and the Honda are the nicest to ride on the road, but they're definitely not the quickest, but they are, you know, nice solid bikes to ride on the road. And the Aprilia, well, the Aprilia's Aprilia, I mean, you know, it works well, and it'll be interesting to see how it goes around the track.
Go on. So we're just going through all the facts and figures and the details. First of all, speed. Well, the fastest bike out there was the Rieju, that did 81.1 mile an hour. Yamaha was second at 79. The Honda was third at 77. And a sporty looking Aprilia was last with a 75 true miles an hour. And then we went to the track. And the slowest bike, the Aprilia, was the fastest around the track. Followed by the Honda, the Yamaha, and the fastest bike, the Rieju, was the slowest around the track. And then on the slow speed, ease of use, what's best for somebody who's just passed the CBT, the Honda comes out on top by far, the Rieju is second, the Aprilia is third, and the sporty Yamaha fourth. Which makes choosing an overall winner, without even considering price, looks, appeal and reliability, a difficult decision. The Rieju is kind of coming at the bottom of the pile really, unfortunately. It is the quickest. It has got little gizmos like the quick shift and the auto blip, but the build quality is pretty poor and the handling is pretty shocking. So then that leaves us with the Aprilia. Now that's the bike most of you are going to want. It looks mouth-watering. Every time you open the garage door, you're going to be impressed by it. And all your mates are going to be really, really jealous, but it's the slowest. And again, reliability, is it going to be 100% like the Japanese too? That leaves us with the Honda and the Yamaha. The Yamaha has got better build quality than the Honda, which is a bit of a surprise, but it is considerably more expensive. If you're willing to pay for the money, then I'd go with the Yamaha. It is more expensive, but it's got the better looks, it's got a nice feel to it, and it's a quality motorcycle. The Honda, if you've just bashed your CBT, you want an easy bike to ride, then you're not going to go far wrong.